I welcome you in the Human Resource Development Center, University of Hyderabad. So as we are in 2 weeks online refresher course on chemistry, which during the 18th November 2021 to 20th November 2021. So myself, Mr. Nitin Boge, working as an assistant professor in the Department of Chemistry, Sri Gnaneshwar Mahavidyalaya, Nevasa. District Ahmednagar from Maharashtra. Okay, so today I will talk on the topic basic principle of UV spectroscopy. Okay, so UV spectroscopy is based on Beer Lambert's law and electronic excitations. Okay, so before going to what is Beer's law, we are let's discuss about some terms used in UV spectroscopy, that is absorbance. Okay, so let's define first what is absorbance. So absorbance is the defined as log of ratio of intensity of incident light and transmitted light. Okay, so let's see what is the mathematical formula for the absorbance. Let's see. So A, that is absorbance is equal to log of I zero minus I. Okay. So here A is the absorbance and I0 is the incident radiation, intensity of incident radiation, and I is the intensity of transmitted radiation. So let's see how to calculate absorbance. Okay, so, suppose this is a light source. Okay, this is a light source of light, and as we know that for UV spectroscopy we need a 200 to 800 nanometer wavelength radiations. Okay, if this source emits a 200 to 800 nanometer wavelength radiation, then these radiations fall on a cuvette containing a sample. Okay, so suppose this is a sample tube or sample cuvette. Okay, in this contains a sample. Okay, if suppose I zero is the intensity of incident radiation, this radiation when falls on the this solution sample solution, then some of the radiations get absorbed by the sample and some of the radiation get transmitted through the sample. Okay, suppose the intensity of transmitted radiation is the I. Okay, so this is a transmitted radiation. And these are the incident radiation. Okay, so according to definition of absorbance, so absorbance is the log of ratio of incident radiation to the transmitted radiation. So this is the formula for absorbance. Okay, Now let's go for the Beer's Lambert's law. Beer's Lambert's law. Okay, let's see statement. Statement for the Beer's Lambert's law. Okay. The Beer's and Lambert's law states that absorbance absorbance of a sample is directly proportional to the concentration capital C and path length of light. Path length of light in bracket small l through cuvette. Okay, so this is the statement for the Beer's Lambert's law. So according to Beer's Lambert's law, the absorbance of a sample is directly proportional to concentration and path length. Okay, so we can write mathematical equation for Lambert-Beer's law. Okay, absorbance is directly proportional to concentration into path length. Okay, so we can remove proportional sign. For that we have to add a coordinate constant called as extinction coefficients. Okay, so epsilon into concentration into path length, where epsilon is the extinction coefficient, molar extinction coefficient. So total UV spectroscopy is based on this law, that is Beer's Lambert's law. Okay. Now next point is the electronic energy levels. Okay, for that call okay, so this is the energy levels. Okay, so we know that this is first electronic level and this is the second electronic level. Okay, so each electronic level is consist of number of vibrational level. Here we can see each electronic level is consist of this red color vibrational level. Okay, these, and these. Okay, so these E2 or E1 energy level, electronic energy level, is consist of number of vibrational level, and each vibrational level is consist of number of rotational level. Okay, so here we can see, so these two vibrational level, this is vibrational level, is consist of number of rotational levels. Here we can see black colors, that is rotational energy levels. Okay, next. Okay, now let's see how electronic excitation takes place. Okay, so this is electronic excitations graph. Okay, here we can see the energy axis and electron orbitals. Okay, so here we can see this is sigma orbitals, this is pi orbitals, and this is non-bonding orbital, this is pi antibonding orbital, and this is sigma star antibonding orbitals. Okay, when the electrons jumps from sigma orbitals to its antibonding orbital, then the transition is called as sigma to sigma star transition. And when electrons jumps from pi to pi star, then this called as pi to pi star transition. And when non-bonding electron jumps from n bonding orbital to sigma star, then this transition or excitation is called as n to sigma star. And lastly, when non-bonding electron jumps from non-bonding to pi star antibonding, then the transition is called as n to pi star. Okay, here we can arrange the transition order in the form of in the energy order. So the maximum energy required for the transition, that is sigma to sigma star, then the less amount of energy is required for the n to sigma star, then pi to pi star, and lastly low energy is required for n to pi star. So here the maximum energy required for sigma to sigma star and lowest energy is required for the transition of from electron from non-bonding to its pi antibonding orbitals. Okay. Okay. With this, I will stop here. Thank you for listening to me. Okay. Thank you.